Hello, good morning, student. Good afternoon, students. Here, in previous class, under the chapter biotechnology, principles and processes, we were discussed regarding cloning vectors. Cloning vectors are nothing but plasmids and bacteriophages. These are present in a bacterial cells. And the numbers are varies from one bacterial cell to another bacterial cell. And when we are going to compare the numbers which are present in a bacterial cell, plasmids are less than the bacteriophages. Bacteriophages are more than the plasmids. Okay, these are all the things we are discussing. Afterwards, we have started regarding the concept. What is that in the sense? Features that are required to facilitate cloning into a vector. We are not transforming into the bacteria, we are cloning into the vector. In the sense, see here, I drawn the diagram of a plasmid named as EBR-322. And we started discussing about the required, in the sense, features that are required to facilitate cloning into the vector. Facilitate cloning into the vector. What are the features which are required for facilitate the cloning into the vector? Vector nagle now alien DNA have become. What are the features are going to facilitate? Those we are started to discussing yesterday. And in yesterday's class or in previous video, we are discussed about what the cloning vector is, that the feature. First feature is origin of replication, we have discussed. Afterwards, we have discussed about the selectable markers. Okay. Now, in today's class, we are going to discuss cloning site. We are going to discuss the cloning site. And last point is to come, that is the vector for the cloning genes in a plants and animals. Okay. First, let us discuss about the cloning site. Okay. So now I will show you, or it is, I draw here the diagram regarding the EBR-322 plasmid. This is the diagram about the EBR-322 plasmid. And we are discussing now regarding the features that required to facilitate cloning into the vector. Vector in the sense, vector, that is what? Plasmid. We are discussing about the plasmid. Understood? PLASMID, plasmid. Now, what are those features in the sense? Yesterday we are discussing about the origin of replication, then selectable markers. Now, first, I would like to tell you about the what we are going to call, that we say, this EBR-322 plasmid. What else it contains? Plasmid or a vector? What else it contains in the sense? Yesterday we have discussed about the origin of replication, that is here ORI, origin of replication. Then here I written ESP1, PUV1, CORI, CAL1, HIND3, BH, SAL1. These all are what we are going to call, these all are represents as restriction sites. These all are restriction sites. What are those? PSC1, PUV1, ECORI, CAL1, HIND3, BH1, these all are, and SAL1, these all are whatever I written outside, these all are restriction sites. These all are restriction sites. What is mean by restriction site? They are going to restrict to express something. That is, these are all restriction site. Okay, restriction site in the sense, restricted enzymes. Restriction enzymes, here we are going to find the enzymes. And afterwards, here I written TMPR, TETR, these are what? Amphimycelin, tetracycline, amphimycelin, and what another one is? Tetracycline. Amphimycelin and tetracycline are nothing but the selectable markers. Amphimycelin and tetracycline are the selectable markers. In the sense, what? Antibiotic resistance genes. These two are antibiotic resistance genes. These two are antibiotic resistance genes. AMPR and tetracycline are the antibiotic resistance gene, and whatever I written outside these all are what restriction site in the sense restricted endonucleates. Okay, and here I written ROP. ROP is nothing but codes for a protein involved in a replication of plasmid. This is codes for a protein. This codes for a protein which is involved in a replication of a plasmid. Plasmid replication agave kaatanga a protein amilla that protein, that is the code of ROP. So sometimes in your what we are going to call that competitive exam, we can see it in agar even diagram value kuda ninge paathundaga questions varthudu. For example, em paathunda idu bitto ee yeda agbodu ee yeda agbodu, then somewhere else here they are to write C, and below these will give the options that I am going to recognize what else is there in a plasmid PBR 322. That is very important. And another thing is, they used to ask you match the following in the sense ROP. What it represents, I told you. ROP, it is codes for the protein involved in the replication of plasmid. It is codes for a protein which is means it is code for a protein which is involved for the replication of plasmid. Plasmid replication agave protein beku. A protein code mark yavuda ROP. ORA antandre enana origin of replication. PST1, EU1, ECORI, ivella enaralla these all are restriction sites. In the sense, you know what HIND3, that is the first restriction enzyme. Okay, that is come under the restriction endonuclease. And afterwards, these mpmycin and tetracycline, these are the two antibiotic resistance genes. Antibiotic resistance genes. And the next, okay, these all are the things you are going to remember regarding the PBR-322. PBR-322. And 2-mark question is going to ask, or a 3-mark question is going to ask, draw an interval diagram of PBR-322. That is for what? 2 marks. Explain the PBR with a neat table diagram. Explain the PBR-322. That is about the 3 marks question. Again, for the part of the diagram, I will again tell you 1, 2, 3. Working in Padella, these all are the restriction sites. These are antibiotic resistance genes. ORA is the origin of peptide replication. And ROP, in front of that ROP is to write, this is the code for a protein which is involved in a replication of plasmid. Which is involved in a replication of plasmid. So this is the homework for you people. You should draw a neat table diagram of PBR-322 and write down below about these all. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, all are restriction sites. Then you write your ORI, and there is a replication of origin of replication, ROP. This is the code for a protein which is involved in a replication of plasmid. Then ampicillin and tetracycline, in front of that you write down these are the what we are going to call that one as a antibiotic resistance genes. Okay, this is about what the diagram, it means diagram about the PBR-322 plasmid. And now we are discussing about the what are the features which are required for the plasmid. It means we used to go for the cloning into the vectors. Elliot DNA cloning into the vectors. What are the features it requires? So in this, in the previous class or in previous video, we have discussed about the origin of replication. We have discussed regarding the origin of replication. We have discussed about the selectable markers in the sense antigen resistant, antibody resistance genes. Those are ampicillin, tetracycline, etc. Now today we are going to discuss about the cloning sites. We are going to discuss about the cloning sites. Cloning sites in the sense, these are 1, 2, 3 cloning sites. These are the restricted sites in the Kerimuru. Here, I return few points regarding the cloning site. In order to link alien DNA, alien DNA in a vector, need to have very few, usually single recognizing site. Here, what we are going to call it as a many recognizing sites are there. The plasmid, it has to have a single or a few recognizing sites. If there are what presence of more than one recognizing site within the vector will generate the several fragments. It will generate the several fragments which cause the complication in a gene cloning. It causes the complication in a gene cloning. In the sense, good vector, if you are going to call any vector or any plasmid that is a good for the cloning, in the sense, it must and should have a single or a very few, what we are going to call them as a recognizing sites. Next, here, the ligation of a alien DNA at a restriction site present in one of the two antibody resistance genes. What we are going to do here in a cloning site, here I written or we draw the two what antibiotic resistance gene we used to join the alien DNA piece to the one of this here or here we used to join. Understood? What I written here? The ligation of a alien DNA, the ligation of alien DNA at a restriction site, at a restriction site here. PSP1A, PV1A is there, BH1 is there. Okay, restriction site present in one of the two antibody resistance genes. In the sense what? This antibody gene has a two restriction site, BH1 and SALU. Amphimycinin, PSP1, PV1 and okay, these two. Understood? So in between these two, used to join alien DNA and a one restriction site. Now, example we are given, what is going to happen and how we are going to select. Right? Now, here see, example. If we are going to ligate the collagen DNA at BH1 site of a tetramycinin resistant gene in vector PBR322. In vector PBR322, if we are going to join the alien DNA to the Beam H1 means restriction site of a tetramycinin R. In the sense here, you are going to join the alien DNA. If suppose, this is the example I am giving here. Right? Then what is going to happen? Recombinant plasmid can be used tetramycinin R resistance due to the insertion. That time what is going to happen? The original plasmid, it is converted into the R plasmid, recombinant plasmid, and that is going to lose what? The tetramycin R resistance due to the insertion. Due to the insertion, tandagina re-alien DNA illi bandu join agana, it is going to what? Due to the insertion, it is going to lose its antibiotic resistance capacity. Now what they are given here, if suppose they lose their antibody resistance capacity due to the insertion of a collagen DNA, but still selected out non-recombinant ones, this is active. Amphimycinin R is active. You are joining the tetramycinin R of a collagen DNA due to the addition of this collagen alien DNA to the tetramycinin, means BH1. Of a tetramycinin, it lose its antibiotic resistance capacity, but other side, the amphimycinin got its antibiotic resistance capacity. Okay, both are present in a plasmid PBR322. Okay, next, what happened here? By planting the transformer on a AMPR containing media, that time what is going to happen? This, now it is converted into the R plasmid. Now in my alien DNA actually R plasmid up to R plasmid tetracycline, it loses its antibiotic resistance gene, means capacity, but still AMP, it is what we are going to call that as a non-recombinants. They are having the capacity of what we are going to call that as a antibiotic resistance. Now what we are going to go for? You are going to introduce this R plasmid, recombinant plasmid, into the media containing AMPR and media containing tetramycinin R. In the sense, tetramycinin and amphimycinin. This you are going to add. happen in the sense. In this case, when we are going to add in these two different medias, in this case, the antibiotic resistance gene helps in selecting the transformant. We are selecting the transformant in the sense, the R means recombinant plasmid. Recombinant plasmid here in what AMPR containing media they are going to grow. They are going to grow, but they are not going to grow in tetramycelin media because tetramycelin is loses its effect. Loses its effect in the sense it loses the antibiotic resistance capacity. So that when we are going to add this R plasmid into the AMPR in the sense ampicillin containing media, that time the transformant R is to grow. And in tetramycelin R, when we are going to transfer this into the tetramycelin R media, that time they are not going to grow. So in this case, what is going to happen? In this case, one antibiotic gene is helped to select the transformant. This one ampicillin means ampicillin. One what we are going to call it today, antibiotic resistance gene is helped to select the transformants. Whereas another antibiotic resistance gene get inactivated. Which one is get inactivated? Tetramycelin. Get inactivated due to the insertion of variant DNA, and it helps in selecting the recombinants. It helps in selecting the recombinants. Understood? Likewise, what we are going to go for the cloning site. If whatever I have written on the board, this is all going to reverse if the alien DNA joins to the ampicillin R. That time these things are changed, reverse. Okay. This is about what origin of replication. This is about the origin of replication. And I draw the diagram regarding the PBR322 plasmid and what else it contains. The PBR322 contains the recognizing sites. It contains the antibiotic resistance genes. It contains the origin of replication. It contains the RU8. RU8 it indicates what? I told you it codes for the proteins involved in the replication of plasmid. Okay, and the example what I given in the sense ligation of a foreign DNA at the beam H1. Ligation of the foreign DNA at a beam. What I told you? The ligation of beam H1. Ligation of DNA at the beam H1 site. Tetramycelin resistance gene is inactivated in vector PBR322. It is going to, example, ligation of a foreign DNA at a beam 1 site, tetramycelin resistance gene in a vector PBR32. Recombinant plasmid can what? Lose tetramycelin resistance due to the insertion of foreign DNA, but still selected out non-recombinant ones by planting the transformant on a ampicillin containing media. Here I drawn two media. One is containing the ampicillin resistance gene and another one is tetracycline resistance gene, and there the transformant can grow in a ampicillin media, but they are not going to grow in a tetramycillin media. So it can help us. One gene, it can help us to selecting the transformant, and one inactivated gene, or what we are going to call it as an inactivated gene, that helps us to selecting the recombinants. This is about what origin of replication. Okay, what else we are discussed about the cloning site, and the cloning site we are discussed about the what recognizing sites, then there are the two antibiotic resistance gene, and when we are going to insert the alien DNA, one what we are going to call that one as a antibiotic resistance gene is inactivated due to the insertion of alien DNA, and one is helpful for the selecting the what we are going to call that one as a transformers. Now here, for that, what is happened in the sense, the selection of recombinant due to the, how we are going to, recombinants are going to select, the selection of recombinants due to the inactivation of antibiotics used to do the inactivation in, antibiotics, it leads to planting on two plants having the two different antibodies. is to have the three different antibodies and one is going to inactivate it. That's what you are able to select the recombinant. One the other way inactivate agbeku aga navu en maartidha aga namge help aagutundaga that can help us to select the recombinant. And when it is possible, if you are going to plant having the means if you are going to planting those what are going to call as the recombinants are planting into the two different plants which are having the two different antibiotics, right? Then therefore alternative selectable markers have to be developed. That's what the alternative in the sense two or alternative what I would call as the selectable markers have to be developed. They can difference that time the alternative recombinants alternative selectable markers can be differentiated recombinants from the non recombinants based on their ability to produce color in the presence of homogenic substrate. In a sense, a simple way, 981, there are two selectable markers. If you are going to join at any restricted site, alien foreign DNA, I give the example, the alien DNA is joined to the tetracycline, that time it is going to lose its antibiotic resistance capacity due to the insertion of alien DNA, but amphimycelin it is active, so that when you are going to plant these recombinant plasmid into the two different containers, one is having the amphimycelin and another one is tetracycline, that time we are going to get transformant and what we are going to call it as a recombinant. In the sense, when we are going to develop two alternative antibodies, that time it can help us to differentiate recombinants from the non-recombinants, and on basis of what they are going to help us, on the basis of their ability to produce the color in the presence of chromogenic substrate. For example, if you are going to introduce the rDNA into the bacteria, and this is going to what interferes with the coding sequence of the beta galactosidase. And it goes to inactivate of this what beta galactosidase enzyme. This beta galactosidase enzyme, and that is what we are going to call as a insertional inactivation. And this beta galactosidase is responsible for the giving the coloration, blue coloration. That is what the blue colored colonies are going to produce. Bacterial blue colored colonies are going to produce if the plasmid does not have any insert. Or plasmid are yavade one alien DNA ni insert madrikil anta idkoli again bacteria already a plasmid sa bacteria irto aga bacteria ena color ena tripanta they are going to produce the blue color. If there is insertion of anything into the plasmid, insert inactivation of these beta galactosidase, that time what is going to happen? If you are going to insert alien DNA or alien DNA means a gene, that time it is going to inactivate the beta galactosidase, and that time it does not have any color, and it means any color for the colonies. In the sense, based upon the blue coloration of colonies and inactivation of beta galactosidase, you are going to recognize or identify the recombinant colonies. Recombinant colonies doesn't give any coloration, and the normal colonies, they are going to give the coloration. Okay, due to the what presence of homogenic substrate in the beta galactosidase. Understood? This is about the what the processor to identify the recombinants and non-recombinants by developing alternative selectable markers which are introduced into the develop the alternative selectable markers. They are present in what plasmids. Okay, this is about for the cloning sites. Cloning sites, just remember when you are going to join the alien DNA, the vector needs to have very few, preferably single recognizing site. Sometimes if they are more than two, a recognizing site within the vector, it will generate the several fragments that can complicate the gene cloning. Then the ligation of DNA carried out with the restriction site present in one of the antibiotic resistance gene. I told you, ಸೈಟ್ ನಾವೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಏನಪ್ಪಾ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಡಿ ಎನ್ ಎ ಲೈಗೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಹೇಳಿದ ಈಗ ಡಿ ಎನ್ ಎ ಲೈಗೇಷನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರಿ ಔಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಂದ್ ಟು ಸಾರಿ ಹಿಂದ್ ಒನ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಟೆಟ್ರಾಸೈಕ್ಲಿನ್ ಟೆಟ್ರಾಸೈಕ್ಲಿನ್ ರಿಜಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಜೀನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಪಿ ವಿ ಆರ್ 32 ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವಾಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಫ್ಟರ್ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಹೌ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ದಿ ರಿಕಾಂಬಿನೆಂಟ್ ಕಾಲನೀಸ್ recombinant colonies are able to recognize the recombinants from the non-recombinants by using the alternative selectable markers. Okay, this is about what cloning site. I will stop here and we will continue next with the last point in the features that require for the facilitating cloning into the vector, that is vectors for cloning genes in a plants and animals. Thank you.